Hello and welcome to the second part of the How to Create a More Modern House tutorial series in uMake. My name is Nico and we are going to continue making this box actually look a lot more interesting. So in the first section, we were able to bring a mannequin in for scale, a vehicle in to also help with scale and kind of help make a place for like a garage or something. And we made a box. Not a whole lot that we did, but it's going to get pretty interesting pretty quickly. So now we have this box, that looks good. Actually, we have two boxes, but this one is just, we're gonna use it more for reference than anything. And we have these scaled. So this is gonna be a pretty big house. This is gonna be, if we select this, it's gonna be 80 feet, 6 inches by 16 feet tall and about 40 or 50 feet deep. Just a pretty big structure, but that's okay. This is gonna be a nice home. What we wanna do from here is we're going to kind of build up some boxes and stack them, and this is going to give us a way to kind of box in the design, literally. So I'm going to select this initial box that we made, and I'm going to copy it. I'm just going to move it straight up, and notice I leave some distance in between. This is so that I can work on them and select them separately without selecting any other curves or ruining the different levels. We're gonna make kind of a three-story home. And so I'm kind of keeping them separate for now. And then I'm gonna actually just make one more copy. And I'm gonna make a fourth one, and I'm just gonna move this kind of diagonal over here for now. And when I'm done, I'm just gonna hit the check mark and I have these sections that I'm gonna work with. So now I have these boxes. Nothing totally interesting, but let's make them a lot more interesting. So the second story, we don't need this to have the 16 feet cathedral ceilings, I don't think. So what we're gonna do is I've selected everything here. I'm just gonna rescale this down and make the ceilings about 12 feet. So should be about 0.8, I believe. Up, and you see I have copy on, so that didn't work. Gotta make sure that I turn copy off. There we go. Don't follow that example. Always make sure to turn copy off when you're done with it. So let's do this again. Rescale it. So 16 feet should be 0.8. That's about 12 feet 9. Let's do 12 feet 6. There we go. That should work. All right. And I'm going to actually just select this edge here and shorten this. I'm just going to bring this in over it like that. You'll see why we do that in a little bit. And then I'm going to do the same for this section. So I selected everything again. I'm going to shorten it about the same length here. And then again, I'm just going to bring this part down. Well, I'll select the whole thing. Bring this down. There we go. Except for this one, I'm going to want to make this a little bit more interesting. So I'm selecting this corner. That's going to be this curve here. And I want this to actually kind of be a little bit more interesting. So I'm going to bring this up. Let's see, where are we? Go to the front view again. It's this corner that I want. Select that. I'm going to bring this over like that, and I'm going to bring this up. And that's going to kind of create this natural angled section that's a little bit different than what we had before and kind of hangs out like that. That should look actually relatively cool. There we go. And then what we have with this fourth one is this is why I moved these over. So I'm going to actually totally change this one. So I'm going to bring this down here. Like this, and then I'm going to bring it over like that and bring it up like that. Now it should be about 25 feet. There we go, 27 feet, that works. There we go. So now we have these various sections, and you can see that pretty quickly the design totally changed. And it's starting to look a lot more interesting than what we initially started with. Now, if we come over to the side, there's not a whole lot of variation here. And so we can actually take care of that. So I'm going to select the curves here on this one. I'm going to make a little kind of rear balcony here. I'm just going to bring this over. And then I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm actually going to extrude this out or pull these curves out and have this kind of overhang, this section coming way out, jutting out of the home. There we go. And also I'm going to do that with this section here. I want to bring this out, and this is going to create kind of a natural balcony for the third floor and a little shade for the first floor. I think we could probably bring this one in just a little bit more. There we go. You can also use the push-pull feature for some of these. So I'm probably going to do that on this side too. And so you can see this is starting to look pretty interesting. It's still kind of exploded, and that's okay. We are going to take care of that in the next couple of tutorials. So I hope you found this interesting. Stay tuned for the third tutorial, where we're going to start adding some windows and some other design features and make this even more interesting. Hope you enjoy this. If you have any comments, questions, feedback for us, definitely let us know down below. You can always reach out to us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and on YouTube. So hope you enjoyed this, and take care. Stay tuned for the next one.